soul so weary. When troubles come, let my heart burden be. And I am still and
hello. Welcome to Motivation with me, as Mwiya, the motivation speaker, and we're still looking at our series we're calling the Seven Dream Killers. We're looking at seven things that stand in the way of people's dreams, seven things that kill people's dreams. And the first one we talked about was fear, and fear can kill your dream if you're afraid of failure or afraid of rejection. Number two, we said procrastination can kill your dream if you keep saying, I'm going to do it tomorrow. You will never do it. Number three, we talked about indecision, failing to make a decision. Many people don't know what they are doing here. They don't know why they are here. They can't make up their mind. That's going to kill your dream. Number four, we talked of lack of discipline. The discipline to do what needs to be done when it needs to be done. Many people are not disciplined enough to do that, so their dreams don't see the light of day. Number five, we talked about lack of perseverance. When you face difficulties, you must be able to stay in there, must be able to hang in there and say, I know it is hard, but I am going to go again. I am going to make it, even out of this difficult situation. And today, part six of the Seven Dream Killers, we're talking of self-doubt. Self-doubt is the lack of belief in yourself, the lack of belief in your capability. You say, I have a dream, but I don't know if I can make this dream a reality. I don't know if I am capable. I don't know if I am the right person who can do this. And many people have that in them. So they walk around and they bury their dreams because they don't think that they are capable of doing things. They don't think that they are able to go out there and make it happen. They look at the background. They say, a person from this background, is it possible for me to make it? A person with this kind of education, is it possible for me to make it? I come from this family, is it possible for me to make it? I come from this village, is it possible for me to make it? So self-doubt begins to creep in and say, I don't think I can do it. So many people have got dreams out there, but they're not willing. They are not going to do anything about those dreams. Why? Because they don't believe in themselves. They don't believe in their dream. They don't believe that they're able to make their dream a reality. They don't believe that their dreams are possible. They don't believe that they're the ones who can achieve those kind of dreams. But here's what you must understand. The dreams that we have were given to us so that we can achieve them. If you have a dream, you must believe that you also have the capacity, or you can develop the capacity to turn that dream into reality. Stop doubting yourself. Start believing in yourself. You are fearfully and wonderfully made. God knew you before you were born, and He brought you this way for a purpose. You are not just here to start to be wandering around. You are here for a reason. And there's a reason why you have that dream that you have. Maybe that dream that you have is the one that's going to change the world in a significant way. But you're doubting yourself. You're saying, how can I do it? Is it possible that I can do it? Is it possible? You know, is it possible that a person like me can do this? So you doubt yourself, and then you go back in your shell and you let your dream die. Then the day comes for you to leave this earth, and you go back with your dream. You must never allow that to happen. Don't go back to the grave with your dream. Stop doubting yourself. Believe in yourself. Believe in the dream that you have. And above everything else, believe in God. Because it is from God that we come. And the dreams that we have were given to us by Him for a purpose. Now, you are put on this earth to inspire other people. You are put on this earth to glow. You are a star. You are a diamond. You are not a nobody. You are a child of God. Stop belittling yourself. Stop talking to yourself in a bad way. Stop talking yourself down. Begin to look in the mirror and see yourself the way that God sees you. God sees you as a child created in His own image. That is how you must begin to see yourself and say, yes, I am fearfully and wonderfully made. I'm here for a purpose. I have this dream that was given to me, and I know this dream was given to me for a purpose. I can go right there and I can make it happen. Don't let what other people say about you. There will be people who don't believe in you. That is okay. They will always be there. But don't be one of them. Don't be one of the people who don't believe in you. If you need one person to believe in you, then let that person be you. Stop doubting yourself. Start believing in yourself. Start believing in your dream. And go after your dream with everything that was given to you. Remember, the dreams that we have were given to us for the purpose that we should achieve them. This is Isaac Mwiya, the motivational speaker. Thank you.